kick the dust up. Long, it's a farm in town. They're making that money grow. Tractors, plows with flashing lights, backing up a two-lane road. They take one last lap around. That sun up high goes down. And then it's on, come on, girl, kick it on back. Z71 like a Cadillac. We go way out.
Hey guys, what's going on? Gavin Pollock here with Outdoor Mayhem. Today I'm going to be prefacing this video on what's in my tackle box. First of all, this is going to be a bass related video. Everything I'm going to be showing you could be used for bass. But anyway, let's get started here. My first plastic bait I'm going to be showing you is a Creme, the original plastic worm. I haven't used these. It's a reusable rig. Sorry if that's backwards to you, but here it is right here. And I have not used these yet, so I'm not going to say anything about them. I mean, they look like a real worm. They have a paddle tail on the back of them for going over lilies and other aquatic plants. Next, I have these Gary Omatos. I've caught a bunch of fish off of these. The limited edition Gary Omato custom baits. They are 5-inch Yamada Cinco's. You can purchase these at your local Field and Stream in Gander Mountain or at your Dick's. These, there's only one called Biospawn. It is made by Biospawn. It is a bio craw. I only have one left, because these are the rock bass in New York love them. And a couple of the bullfins will like them too, depending on what color of the day is, or how light it is or dark out it is outside. But there it is right there, Biospawn. It's supposed to resemble a crayfish, but I think it looks like a frog to me. Tell me what you think it looks like down below. Next up we have the Spiny's TRD Green Pumpkin, made by Z-Man. These are scented with garlic and salt, and they're green pumpkin. These I've had no luck with, but also I haven't used them as much. But yeah, let's keep going. Next up we have a Stanley Reel It Feel It Sidewinder Rattle Chamber and Tail Plastic Bait. And as it said, there's a rattle chamber right back here. I don't know if you can hear that. But these, when you're going to use these, make sure you use them in like a lily pad area zone. Don't use them in just open water. I mean, you want these to fall in between lily pads and other aquatic plants. These are probably best in small lakes and just ponds. These I've caught. This is called the Reaction Strike Fathead Junior TM. These are four inch. I got these in a Lucky Mystery Box or Lucky Tackle Box. Reaction Strike is supposed to resemble a type of perch. Well, that's what it says it's supposed to resemble, but I don't see it. But anyways, these I've caught one small bass off in a pond again. And yeah, let's keep going. We have kind of like that, what do you call it, the bio spawn. The same kind of shape, let me show you. These are not scented, well they are scented with salt, I should say. This is called the Z-Man 10 times tough Batwing Green Pumpkin, and it's kind of like the Vile Craw, almost, just the Vile Craw is sparkly blue. But anyway, let's keep going. Okay, and next up we have Lures with an Attitude, Lake Fork Trophy Lures. This is very highly scented, I mean, pungent scented. And I've caught tons of bass off of these. Too many bass off these, but I'm not complaining. Right there. They're like, these are really good for the Texas rig or the weightless rig. All of these are, I should say. These, in Last Guy, says bass and other trophy fish, but I've caught a pike off of this. It was a pickerel. I caught a pickerel off of this. And I lost a bunch. That's why empty. That's made by Berkeley. It's a power bait with extra scent, bio salt. And next is another Lake Fork garlic and salt. These I've had luck at Burt's Dam with. Right here. This is favored, it says on the back, right here. Tells you a bunch of ways on how to rig it. Right there. Keep going. Now, these, I did not use last year and they're kind of messed up. But, they smell like sausage. But here they are right here. They look like a baby bass, kind of. This is made by Bruiser Baits. I'm going to use those a lot this year. I'm just going to try to use a lot of bigger baits this year, because last year I used a lot and caught a lot, but I want to catch a lot more this year, like everyone else. Now this, I don't know how this got in here. It's made by Gulp. Or Berkeley, it's a Gulp. It is a chartreuse, 4-inch swimming mullet. And this is for salt water, but I guarantee you can catch tons of bass, freshwater bass, largemouth, smallmouth, maybe a couple of Rockies, or a black bass. I guarantee you catch it. I mean, that's chartreuse, it's made for stripers, but I think it would be good for just using a largemouth or a smallmouth. But here you go, this, a couple different rigging techniques. And these I bought in Connecticut when we went there to see family. It's like an orange. Yeah, it's excellent. Fish love that too. Comment down below, subscribe, share with your friends, and leave a like. And goodbye. Outro.